What's going on? What's going on? I am back down at the hole. I'm doing a lot of the prep work so we can do this Monday coming up. That's tomorrow. It's Sunday. It's beautiful. I might as well get some prep work done and ready so I can start slapping that mud together and get this kicker walls done as quick as possible, because I want to get everything up to 7 high so we can figure out what we're going to do with the pouring. I gotta get these cut in order for me to lay them down. It's a little bit of a tricky cut because I do have to tie in right there at the corner. So I gotta do a 45 degree cut that way. And yeah, we'll get that tackled. I've got 3 half blocks that I need to do on this side, as well as 3 on that side, as well as 4 full blocks on this side and that side. So 6, 8, get those done. And then on the ends, I'm going to make sure that I just measure it out perfectly to where all I need to do is a half on the end and full half, blah, 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 go back and forth and be able to actually get it exactly where I need it to be. And I don't have to sit here and cut any more blocks. That's the plan. I hope I can get it done. I have faith in myself. Let's get it. So what I'm gonna end up doing, I've got whole blocks. I didn't get half blocks. So it actually saved me quite a bit of money, but it makes it to where I have to cut each block to get a half a block. It's not exactly 8 inches or 16 inches this way. It's not exactly 8 inches this way. What makes up the difference on everything with blocks is the mortar. This is probably the same thing with brick too. So getting the measurement is a little tricky in a sense, because it's not exactly readily available on the tape measure I've got. It's actually a 16th of an inch, and my tape measure does not have 16ths. But I marked it in between 7/8 and 6/8. So got myself plugged in, got my mask on, got my safety glasses on. I'm good to go. I'm just worried about, hopefully I don't end up breaking one side or the other. So now I got that side, I'm just gonna come on this side, hit it on that, go down the angle, and I'll have that 45 that way. Fighting me there for a second. I'm pretty much right on that center, minus the blade width. Yeah, I mean, it's pretty straight. All the little break-offs or whatnot don't matter. The mortar is actually going to cover that up. You'd be surprised on some of these bricks coming from the factory where how some of these are like chipped and whatnot on the corners and everything else, but the mortar definitely hides a lot of it and makes it really nice. So I gotta flip this guy, do the same thing. I hope they come out even. Look at that. That's a pretty nice 45 to 45. That should be perfect, man. That's, dang. Heck yeah. I like that. I'm gonna flip this guy. And just like that, I got 2 half inch 45s. It's partly why I like having full bricks. And it makes it a little easier. Now, I've got a interesting piece left. Let's go look at this. I'm really curious on this. All right, let's see this. I mean, there she is. Man, that hugs it really nice. And then the mortar, so the mortar gap will have, it's not 100% level, but when I get the mortar in and set, it will actually be level. It will set in nice. All my 45s cut. I actually went ahead and made my straight edge on my corner here so I can actually level everything out. As well, as you can see, I got a screw in the wall right there. That's so I can actually tie a string to it. I'll stake it down over here. So I'm all ready and good to go for tomorrow when I start mudding and getting everything done. But I have all the bricks cut, so I'm really happy about that.
What's up, you guys?
What's going on?
As you saw yesterday, made all those awesome cuts for the kickers. So yes, we should be ready to rock and roll on those today. But first, before we do that, we got to finish up this seventh row high right here on this last little bitty side. And then everything will be seven high, the eights in the front, the eights in the middle, the 12s going all the way around. We'll be good to go and ready to move on to the eights that are the kickers.
Yep. I've got to get on this because there ain't no time like the present. So let's get it.
got the right kicker all the way to 7 high today. I can't freaking believe it. Gary, you're picking up some major speed with those blocks, man.
Man, I kicked it today. And I really, really have to appreciate the fact that all of the pieces were already cut.
Yes, that actually made it a lot better for you.
Yes, it made it to where I could just go and go and go and go and bam, got it done.
Yeah, so the prep work, although it is tedious, it is very, very important.
Yes, it's a lot of time and it's a huge time consumer if you're having to do it as well as mud.
Yeah. Yeah, so it's best, I guess we're learning, it's best to have all the cuts pre-made so that way we can just, you know, slap it together when the time comes. But guys, we are going to be calling it a day for today. We are going to be coming back out here tomorrow to work on that kicker over there. We already have the block set up, the mud ready to go. Everything now is 7 high. We got the whole front 7 high right here. We did finish that area over there as well. And then we got this kicker. Tomorrow is looking like it's gonna be the last really nice day of this week weather-wise. So we're hoping that we can really kick butt tomorrow and accomplish the same thing we did today and finish that kicker out before the weather goes south on us, so. Now we're going to start working on this kicker. The forecast for today, we are expecting some rain, so we did some prep and we set up our tent, so hopefully we can still keep kicking butt if it does start raining. We've got everything set up. This is kind of how we do some of the prep. What we like to do in the morning is Gary comes out, he makes sure that the lines are where they need to be. We bring a bunch of the blocks down where they need to be so it makes it a lot easier and smoother. We set everything up so that way when it's execution time, we can just bing, bang, boom, slip, slap, done.
You can see that I had to chop this side of the rebar as well. I had to chop some in the front, which I knew was gonna end up happening if I had to chop any. Thankfully, the kicker over there, I didn't have to chop any, but this kicker was thrown off.
Yeah, Gary did have to come through and chop the rebar out. So how are you going to remedy that?
What I'm ended up doing is I'm actually going to drill a hole into the ground for a new piece of rebar, go in a good depth, smack another piece of rebar in, and be able to go from there. But I'm going to actually put the first row down. And then I'm just gonna go every fourth cell and actually get it done. So
sweet. All right, well, we're gonna start this day, get it rocking and rolling. We are hoping to complete this other kicker today, and then we'll have 7 high all around the entire building, and we'll be able to get the concrete poured at that time. So we got a lot to do today. Cross your fingers, throw a little salt over the shoulder, rub your lucky rabbit's foot, go pick a 4-leaf clover for us, say a prayer, all that fine stuff. We're hoping we can get it done. Let's get it. So it started sprinkling just a little bit and it came down heavy for like a minute. And so me and Gary freaked out and we made our tarp a little bit better because the rain was coming in at an angle. So we need to protect the mud. We need to protect all of our camera gear and all of our stuff. So we went ahead and made a fort real quick. But yeah, we're going to keep going on this. Gary's already got the first row all the way in. He's got the second one started and now he's starting on the third, and he's going to use the corners up like how we did on the other side. That way he can build the lead and keep it level and straight. So we're making really good progress despite the unpredictable weather today, raining like hell for, you know, a minute and now it's all dry again. So Yeah, it's making things a little bit interesting, but that's what makes it fun. So we're going to keep on going, and hopefully we'll finish this this kicker. Oh, guys, we're finished with the kickers.
Ooh, I'm so excited. That was so much work, and we have kicked our butts in the last couple of days. Like,
that work rocked us, dude. That was a lot of strain on the body. My neck, my back.
Yes.
My neck and my back.
But guess what? We get to relax tomorrow. Yeah. We can sleep in a little because we have no more block work until the concrete is done.
Yep. So. You hear that, guys? Everything now is 7 blocks high. The 8-inch on the kickers, the 8-inch on the front, the other kicker, the 8-inch on the middle, and then the 12s going all the way around. It's all 7 high. It's got some rebar in it. It's got some DuraWire in it. Gary and I do have to put more rebar inside some of those holes. But the block work is essentially done. So the next thing that we're going to have to be looking forward to doing is giving the concrete company a call and getting it actually scheduled for us to get these holes filled. Yep. So
we've got that going on. We've also going to be doing the septic, trying to schedule that this week, as well as we've got the
trenches.
Well over there that we got to plumb over. We got electric we got to plumb over. So,
we got a lot of phone calls we're making now and scheduling situations happening because we are at the point in our build where we need some of the professionals to come in and do their thing so then Gary and I can keep doing our thing. So,
yep. I mean, this is insane. This is something that normally you call the professional to just come out and do
to get this far, right?
And it makes me happy that we were able to accomplish this far. And this makes me happy knowing that we're going to be able to finish it.
Yeah.
Get it done.
It looks so good, guys. I'm so impressed. Yes. Like, and having the kickers really changes the feel of everything. Now you get a better idea of how big the patio is going to be, how big the deck above us is going to be. It's not a small house. It's definitely not a tiny house.
No, this is not a tiny house. This is literally our dream home. This is the dream home that we've always wanted.
Yeah.
And we're going to be able to make it happen.
Heck yeah.
Like, I mean, go big or go home.
Shoot, and if we can't.
Either way, we're going to be going home. So.
Yeah, we're already in our home, right? I can't wait until we're actually inside the basement, man.
Yep.
Like, that's our big goal now for the next couple of months is to get all these other little things, all the ducks in a row, get all these little finishing things done, finish going 13 blocks high, so that way we can live in it while we hit the rainy season. That's the big thing, is we want to be in here before the rainy season.
Yes. So. And once we get all 13 up, We get the septic in. This dirt level will be brought up a little bit. I'll be able to put the French drains in, get my trenches dug for all that fun stuff. And we'll be able to seal and bury this basement.
Yeah, there's still a lot of steps left to do to build a basement.
Yes.
I, for one, am really happy that we are done with the block work until we get some more people out here. So the next couple of weeks is going to be a lot of phone calls, a lot of scheduling,
and then arrangements,
and then the other things that we got to do in order to make all that other stuff happen too. So you guys are going to have a lot of stuff to come along with. But for now and for today, the sun is basically down, and I am so tired. My neck hurts so bad. Gary's back hurts. We're hungry. Got to wrap it up. But I hope you guys are pretty impressed, because, man, we're impressed. Like, holy heck, guys. I can't believe that we did this by ourselves. And with a little help from Abe. Ain't that right, buddy?
Yeah.
Of course.
Yeah, did you help us? You good boy.
I lift up the blocks.
Yeah, and you help sweep and clean. I want a big high five for all that hard work you put in. Give me some boom. That's right. That's like, right.
Daddy needs some too. You did a really good job today, buddy. Good job.
Anyhow, guys, I think I can't really think of anything else that I need to report at this time.
I'm tired.
Yeah. We're going to be calling it. So we love y'all. And until the next one, we hope you have a good one.
And we'll catch you on the next one, you guys.
Bye, you guys.
Bye. Later, later.
I can't get over with how good that looks, guys. I'm just like...
Honestly, I was thinking the same thing.
You want to come see it? You want to come see it over here?
Yeah, I want to come right to the middle.
Me too. Oh, man. And that beautiful pink sky right now, too. Mm-hmm. It's gorgeous.
Right here is the middle.
It looks good.
This is really awesome.
You like the basement?
Yeah.
You've been putting in a lot of hard work, dude.
I know.
You're awesome. You're awesome, Abe.
You're awesome, Mom.
Aww. I love you, Bubba.
Love you, too.
Ah. Hey, and when you grow up one day, Abe, you can tell everybody, when you're an old man and this basement is still here, you could tell all your grandkids, I helped build that with your great-grandparents. Yep, when you're a grandpa, you can tell all the stories about how when you were a little kid, you got to be out here building the house with us.